So for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at questions where we're dividing using long division. And these are going to involve questions where we don't have remainders. So for this first example, I've got 182 divided by 7. So I'm going to start by drawing my lines. I'm going to have 182 on the inside and then 7 on the outside. So what we want to do first is see how many 7s can we fit into 1. Well, that would be 0. So I can write a 0 above the 1 here. But what I'm going to do is just move along to my next digit, which is an 8. So now I want to see how many 7s fit into 18. Well, I can fit 2 7s into 18 because 7 times 2 is actually 14. So I'm going to write that underneath the 18. We're then going to take that 14 away. So I'm going to put my line under, I'm going to take away. So we've now got 18 take away 14. We've lined up the digits, and this is great for examples where we've got trickier numbers, so we can use column subtraction. But for this one, we know 18 take away 14, that's just going to leave us with 4. So once we've done the subtraction, we then bring the next digit down. So we've got this 2, so we're going to bring that down and we're going to put it next to our 4. So we've now got 42. So now we want to see how many times does 7 fit into 42? Well, that fits in 6 times exactly, because 7 times 6 is 42. So when we subtract those numbers, we get 0. So because we've got 0, we know there's going to be no remainder. So our final answer would just be 26. So 182 divided by 7 is 26. Okay, so practicing that method again, we've now got 285 divided by 5. So the first thing we want to do is see how many times does 5 fit into 2. Well, we can't fit 5 into 2. So we're going to move across to the next digit, so we've now got 28. So 5 into 28 will go 5 times, so I'm going to put the 5 above the 8, because 5 times 5 is actually 25. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract that from the 28, so we've got 28 take away 25, which leaves us with 3. So now that we've done that, we move across to the next digit, which is a 5. So I'm going to bring that down, so I've now got 35. So we now want to see how many times does 5 fit into 35? Well, that'll go 7 times, because 7 times 5 is 35 itself. So when we subtract those numbers, 35 take away 35 is 0. So again, because we've got a 0, we know we don't have any remainder. So the answer to 285 divided by 5 is actually 57. Okay, so we've got some more examples to have a go at now. Feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. Okay, for this first question, we've got 192 divided by 4. So first of all, we want to see how many 4s fit into 1. We can't fit any 4s into 1, so we're going to bring in the next digit. So now we want to see how many 4s fit into 19. Well, 4s will go into 19 4 times, because 4 times 4 is 16. So now I'm going to take that away from the 19. So 19 take away 16 leaves me with 3. Now that I've done that, I'm going to bring down my next digit. So bringing down the 2, I now want to see how many 4s will fit into 32. Well, 4s into 32 will go 8 times, because 8 times 4 is 32 itself, so that when I subtract them, I get 0, leaving me with no remainder. So the answer here would be 48. Moving on, we've now got 711 divided by 9. So how many times can we fit 9 into 7? We can't, so we're going to move across to the next digit. So we've now got 71. So how many times will 9 fit into 71? Well, we can fit 7 9s into 71, because 7 times 9 is 63. So now we want to subtract 63 from 71. As I said earlier, this is a great example where lining the digits up is extremely useful, because now we can use the column method. So I've got to do 1 take away 3, so I'm going to borrow from the 7. So 7 becomes 6, and the 1 comes across, so I've now got 11. So 11 take away 3 gives me 8. I've then got 6 take away 6, which is 0. So my answer to that would just be 8. So now I'm going to bring down my next digit, which is a 1. So now we've got 81. We want to see how many times does 9 fit into 81? Well, it'll fit in 9 times, because 9 times 9 is actually 81. So when we subtract it, we end up with 0, leaving us with no remainder. So we know our answer to 711 divided by 9 is 79. Okay, so again, we've got a couple more examples to have a go at here. Again, feel free to pause the video and have a go at these. And again, we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. So for this first question, we have 2,905 divided by 7. So we want to see how many times does 7 fit into 2? Well, it doesn't, so we're going to bring in the next digit. So 7s into 29 will go 4 times, because 7 times 4 is actually 28. So now we want to take that away from the 29. So 29 take away 28 leaves us with 1. So now that we've done that, we're going to bring down the next digit. So bringing down the 0, I've now got 10. So 7s into 10 will go once, because 7 times 1 is 7. So now taking them away, 10 take away 7 leaves us with 3. I'm now going to bring down my final digit. So bringing down the 5, I've now got 35. So I want to see how many times does 7 go into 35? Well, that'll go 5 times, because 7 times 5 is 35. So when we subtract them, we're left with 0. So we have no remainder. So our answer to 2,905 divided by 7 is 415. And for our final example today, we have 2,682 divided by 3. So 3s into 2 don't go, so we move along to our next digit. 3s into 26 will go 8 times, because 8 times 3 is 24. So we're then going to do 26 take away 24, which leaves us with 2. So now that we've done that, we bring down our next digit. So bringing down the 8, I've now got 28. So now we want to see how many 3s will fit into 28. Well, we can fit 9 3s into 28, because 9 times 3 is 27. So I want to take them away. So we've got 28 take away 27, which leaves us with 1. I'm then going to bring down my final digit, which is a 2. So I've now got 12. How many 3s can we fit into 12? Well, we can fit 4 3s. Into 12, because 3 times 4 is actually 12 itself. So when we subtract these, we're left with 0, so we have no remainder, meaning our answer would just be 894. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.